stage here at the Microsoft Build Live. And I have Sam George with me today. Sam is here to talk about IoT. Sam is the lead for the Azure IoT engineering team. And Sam, before we jump into the questions and the topic, we have some questions that people can ask. So you can jump in the link that is between here and ask your question, and we'll try and answer them. Sam, thanks for joining.
Thanks for having us.
So you had a great session today to talk about the vision of IoT and the roadmap. So what's up with IoT these days?
Yeah, there's a lot. So one of the things that we like to talk about in IoT is really what it's doing for every business on the planet. And that's really transforming it. You know, businesses today have so much that they don't know about, so much including how are their operations doing, how are their products being used, what do their customers think, what are their employees doing, and IoT enables us to help them connect all of those into something we call a digital feedback loop, which gets better and better and smarter over time.
So we've been on a journey, actually, correct?
We have been on a journey,
a few years ago, and we progressively are growing. So can you tell us a bit about that journey?
Very much. And in fact, I was just doing the talk here. I think it was in the same room where 4 years ago we were talking about, hey, we have cloud services you can connect IoT devices to now. And you know, that was just in preview, and now we're talking about digital twins and plug-and-play IoT and making things go faster. And the bigger frame of what we see happening is that the first couple of years were really about enabling IoT to be possible, to be possible at scale so that you could really have millions of devices sending trillions of messages. And the journey that we've been on over the last couple of years has been about making IoT easy, making it so that I can go from zero to a full solution very, very quickly.
Yeah.
And we've really gotten to the point now with offerings like IoT Central, which is our SaaS offering for IoT, where you can provision a device or provision an application in about 15 seconds, configure it in a couple hours, and go to production the same day. It's pretty incredible from where we've come from
a couple of years. We're coming from far away, right?
Yeah. And then as we look forward to the future, it's about enabling the connectivity of every business on the planet to enable them to be able to model their entire business, know what's happening in all aspects of it, optimize it, and really put them on equal footing with a lot of the disruptors that are coming to join the party.
So as we're moving towards that like third wave, you describe this like that. So we're moving toward that third wave, and we're bringing new technology that are actually layering on top of the existing one while we're still adding features and functionality down there. Can you tell us about the big announcements that we did or that you actually did during your session today?
Absolutely. So we talked about how we have a really well-composed and layered stack that really starts with our IoT and edge capabilities, our platform services, and on top of that, Azure Digital Twins and IoT Central. And one of the big new initiatives that we've got for this upcoming wave is something we call IoT Plug and Play. And it really borrows on a previous wave of innovation that we saw many decades back with Windows, where you had a state where if you wanted to develop a peripheral, like a keyboard or a mouse, you had to build software or firmware for the device as well as for Windows and keep those two in sync. And it was super fragile, tight coupling. And what we're doing with IoT Plug and Play is bringing the innovations that really Windows brought for Plug and Play to IoT. And the way that we're doing that is we're doing it first and foremost in an open source way using open standards. It's fully cross-platform, works on any operating system, any device. And at its core, it's really a capability model that the device can present when it connects to a cloud solution. And then the cloud solution can know everything about that device, telemetry that it sends, state that it synchronizes, commands it receives. And the net effect is that when it connects, it just lights up. It plugs into the solution. It starts sending data. All the dashboards are populated. You know everything the device does.
Got it.
You can make IoT go really fast.
Got it. So that will require the hardware manufacturers actually to get on board, right? So what's actually in it for them, and what will they have to do to get on board the plug and play?
Absolutely. Well, the nice part is it's a really low bar to get on board. So we already have this Azure IoT or Azure Certified for IoT program, and we're adding capabilities for plug and play as well. We also have support in Visual Studio Code for authoring these plug and play models and then generating software that's compatible with them. Super easy. Just really eliminates a lot of the toil that you typically see.
Yeah.
The benefits for them then once they do this is they get to be part of an ecosystem with thousands of solutions that'll just be compatible with those devices. So it helps them get to a much higher scale and to get going fast.
Yeah, so the scenario I would imagine is I'm in IoT Central, I'm building an app, I want to add a device, access the catalog, I see the plug and play checkbox.
Exactly. Right?
And then that means that I will just add this device to my solution.
I can just add that device, and even better, we're making it work with our simulation service. So you'll be able to go to the device catalog and say, simulate what this device can do in my IoT Central application. And I can see it before I even get the device.
So the application that Ashley was mentioning just before, plug and play is the device side of the story, right?
Like
making them super easy to connect.
Yep.
And then there's the backend side of things. So aggregating all the services that it takes to create an IoT application is not trivial. You need to have a device cloud gateway to manage your devices. You need to do transformation of the data. You need to store different
ways data, analytics.
You need to apply real-time analytics.
Yep.
You need to implement rules, display the data, and so forth, right?
Don't forget high availability and disaster recovery and geo-availability and all of these things.
Yeah. So all of that is actually served through that SaaS application platform you're
IoT
talking
Central
about.
IoT Central takes care of that.
Yep. There's some news around Central, because being SaaS, actually, we're adding new features on the go. While people are actually already in production. They're getting new goodies.
They get new features that just light up.
What are the latest ones?
Yeah. So there's a whole bunch of features that we've delivered in IoT Central since its general availability last year. We've done multiple dashboards, so you can have a homepage with that's user personalized. Mm-hmm. You can toggle through multiple dashboards. We have a whole new set of options for exporting data from IoT Central continuously. For example, to Service Bus and Event Hubs in addition to storage, with more coming. We have an inline Microsoft Flow experience, so that as you're monitoring data from IoT devices and looking for patterns, you can automatically trigger Microsoft Flow actions, as well as Logic Apps, Webhooks, Azure Functions, and a bunch of others. We have personalization. So this morning in the keynote, you saw Starbucks in pilot with IoT Central connecting to Azure Sphere devices with the Guardian modules so that they can connect to their on-prem coffee machines.
Yep.
And it had a nice Starbucks look and feel to it. That's part of our personalization features. So a whole bunch of new features.
That's great for IoT Central. And so we're mentioning the many things that IoT Central does. IoT Central happens to be built on these PaaS services.
Same exact platform services.
So
that's right.
Time Series Insights, Azure Maps. These actually, we talk less about them, but they're crucial, right? Because when it comes to data insights, you know, you really need to have these services being super rich and powerful. And so we also bring some news to TSI and to Maps.
Yep.
Like top of your head, a couple of these.
Absolutely. Well, with Azure Maps, we've got a bunch of great set of innovations that we've brought. Number one is that we already announced a partnership with MoveIt. Mm-hmm. So we've introduced Azure Maps mobility services that takes advantage of all of those things. We have a bunch of new geospatial capabilities as well. And with Time Series Insights, we're adding long-term storage support. So you'll be able to collect petabytes of IoT data and have part of it in very fast, you know, sub-second query capabilities and some of it in long-term storage with still just single-second capabilities. Mm-hmm. For querying, but much, much less expensive. And all of that, you're absolutely right. Like, the reason why you do these IoT solutions is for the insights that you gain over the data that these devices are collecting. So we're making Azure Time Series Insights super powerful. And, of course, it's the underpinnings of Azure IoT Central, so all its capabilities are represented there as well.
So I've been asked a lot, and that might be a tough question, which is IoT Central has been perceived as something that was very much more of a proof of concept thing.
Yep.
Right. It's like pretty straightforward, click, 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 looks good, and you're just like, okay.
Yeah.
So what's the strategy midterm and long term with IoT Central?
Absolutely. So we have a rich, rich, rich roadmap set for IoT Central. And it really started off focused on enabling a discrete application right, to be produced. We've obviously, as I mentioned, we're making it available with, or making it IoT plug and play capable. Mm-hmm. That's going to speed things up a lot. And in my talk, I demonstrated connecting an IoT Edge device to it and being able to stream video with AI overlays right into IoT Central and to be able to manage the containers that are running out on or the workloads that are running out on IoT Edge. So a whole bunch of new developer extensibility points that are coming in addition to that personalization one. And really part of the vision with IoT Central is to turn it into a hosted application platform that really enables you to write applications and deliver it to your customers as a partner or as a developer without worrying about all the toil. And you know, we really wear the pager.
Is that fair to say the direction we're going will be like the Dynamic 365 for IoT?
That's a good way of thinking about it, like IoT 365 in a lot of ways. Yeah.
Cool.
But again, cleanly layered on top of the platform. Mm-hmm. And you can get to any of the layers that make the most sense to you, but very well composed.
Yeah. So another technology that actually was announced last year or so, it's called digital twins.
Yes.
I'd like for you to give us an update of where digital twins is at.
Absolutely.
And where it's going in the near future.
Yeah. So digital twins is currently in public preview. We'll have some exciting announcements later this year. What we showed as part of my talk was that digital twins get used in environments for IoT where you're modeling a physical environment. Mm-hmm. It's scenarios like you're going into a stadium or a building or an electric grid where knowing the layout and the sort of topology of the